Hi, I am Senior Clerk Noli Christopher Gabia and I will be discussing about breastfeeding. So breastfeeding is an essential part of the newborn's life. It provides the newborn with the total nutritional and emotional dependency on the mother. It should be initiated soon after birth unless medical conditions preclude them. It is highly recommended to continue exclusive breastfeeding until 6 months of age. Some of the advantages of breastfeeding are nutritional, immunological, developmental, psychological, social, economical, environmental, optimal growth and development, and decreases risk for acute and chronic diseases. After delivery, the breast will begin to secrete colostrum. This is a deep lemon-yellow liquid that is rich with immunological components. It can be expressed from the nipples at the second postpartum day. The IgA in the colostrum offers protection to the babies against enteric pathogens. Its secretion will persist for 5 days to 2 weeks and then gradually transition into the mature milk by 4 to 6 weeks. The mature milk is a complex and dynamic biological fluid that contains fat, proteins, carbohydrates, bioactive factors, minerals, vitamins, hormones, and many cellular products that are essential for the newborn. Care for the breast. The most significant care for the breast during breastfeeding is to keep it clean and paying attention to any skin fissures. If fissures develop, it will make breastfeeding painful for the mother and it will have deleterious influence on milk production. The cracks will provide a portal of entry for bacteria to invade. In severe fissures, the mother should not continue breastfeeding on the affected side. She can instead empty regularly with a pump until the breast is healed. It is helpful to wash the areola with water and soap before and after nursing, as dried milk can accumulate and irritate the nipples. If irritated, topical lanolin or a nipple shield can be applied for at least 24 hours. Poor latching by the baby can also contribute to the formation of fissures. Ideally, both the nipple and the areola are taken in to evenly distribute the suckling forces. If the baby is only sucking the nipple, this will increase the risk of fissure formation. Additionally, proper suckling will aid in efficient emptying through the force of the hard palate on the lactiferous sinuses while the nipple is positioned closer to the soft palate. Mothers should nurse at each breast at each feeding, starting with the breast offered second at the last feeding. It is preferred to empty the first breast first before offering the second in order to completely empty both the breast and therefore better milk production. This is the pattern of milk supply. On day 1, some milk may be expressed. On day 2 to 4, there is lactogenesis and milk production increases. On day 5, milk is present and full and leaking are felt. And on day 6 onward, the breast should feel empty after feeding. Signs that a baby is ready to nurse are collectively called feeding cues. And this includes bringing the hands to the mouth, rooting, that is moving the head as if looking at the nipple, mouth opening, lip licking and sucking, clenching of fingers and fists over the chest and abdomen, bending of arms and legs, and fussiness. It is important to feed the baby 8 to 12 times a day in the first week. Different breastfeeding positions. The most important thing to consider is the mother's and the baby's comfort. Therefore, learning the proper breastfeeding positions can help the mother and the child during the breastfeeding process. Some of the most common breastfeeding positions are modified cradle position, football hold, cradle position, and side lying. In the modified cradle position, the baby is held in the crook of the arm opposite to the feeding breast. The hand should support the base of the head, neck, and shoulders. Meanwhile, the other hand is used to support the mother's breast with the fingers underneath and the thumb on top, well back from the areola. The baby should be facing the mother. Placing a pillow can help the baby's body close to the breast. This is useful when the mother and the baby is still learning to breastfeed. The football hold is where the baby is facing the mother with his legs tucked under the mother's arm. The head is supported by the thumb and index finger behind the ears and the body with the arm. The breast is supported by the other hand. This position may be helpful if the mother had cesarean section or breastfeeding twins. Just like the first position, a pillow can help bring the baby to the height of the breast. The cradle position. The baby is lying across the mother's lap facing the mother. The baby's head is rested on the forearm and his neck along the arm. Pillows can help lift the baby to the level of the nipple. This position is most helpful in older babies who are breastfeeding well. The side lying position can take time to master, but this will allow the mother to rest while breastfeeding. The mother and her baby lie on their sides facing each other. The baby can be cradled with the mother's arm along the baby's back. To properly stimulate the nipple and remove milk from the breast and ensure that there is an adequate supply and good flow, the baby needs to be well attached so that he can suckle effectively. Latching the baby correctly leads to successful breastfeeding and helps in preventing the formation of fissures. The signs of good attachment are: much of the areola and the tissues underneath, including the larger ducts, are in the baby's mouth. Breast is stretched to form a long teeth, but the nipple only forms one third of it. Baby's tongue is forward over the lower gums beneath the milk ducts, and baby is sucking from the breast, not the nipple. Once again, this is Senior Clerk Nolly Christopher Gavia, and thank you for watching.